Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. We have already discussed about mechanical seals. In this video, we shall learn how to analyze defects of mechanical seal and how to repair and recondition mechanical seals. Possible leakage path in mechanical seal. A picture of mechanical seal is given where we can see the leakages may come from mechanical seal due to sealing on shaft. This one, seal faces, both the mating seal faces. This is a o-ring provided in the stationary seal face of the mechanical seal. This damage of o-ring may also cause a leakage, and this is a o-ring provided in seal gland to the stiffing box may also a reason for leakage. Face leakage may occur due to chipped or cracked carbon. If our mating faces are cracked, that may also cause a leakage. Stationary seal o-ring failure leak through stiffing box, as we discussed. Rotary seal o-ring failure cause leakage along shaft. Here we have already seen. Spring damage may cause reduction in compression load on seal face. Seal face may open, cause leakage. Gasket between shaft and sleeve cause leakage. Shaft sleeve gasket damage. Seal plate gasket may cause leakage through gland plate. Flattening or pitting on shaft or shaft sleeve. If our shaft or shaft sleeve are corroded or having pitting marks, that may also cause for leakage. Damaged or corroded stiffing box face. If stiffing box faces are corroded, that may also lead to leakage. Reasons of mechanical seal failure. Mechanical seal failure seem to fall into four broad categories. The seal motion was restricted and the face opened. If our seal faces will open due to any restriction in the seal motion, then leakage may occur. Heat caused the o-ring to deteriorate. Due to pressure and velocity of seal faces, heat will be generated in the seal chamber. So that can cause of o-rings to deteriorate. O-rings are made of rubber. O-rings are not suitable for very high temperature. Therefore, leakage can start from mechanical seal. The seal material were attacked by the fluid seal. The fluid which is used for sealing of the seal, or a fluid which is handled by the pump. If are of corrosive nature, then they can attack to the seal material, and seal material can corrode or have a pittings. So that can also lead to failure of mechanical seal. The seal was installed incorrectly. If the seal is not installed properly with due care and a correct measurement, then seal will not function. How to analyze damage in mechanical seal? A picture of damaged component of mechanical seal is shown for your reference, where you can see seal failure due to a large extrusion gap. If rotating parts having large clearances, then they can be cause of a failure due to extrusion. However, general conditions and conditions of rotating drives shall be noted while analyzing the damage in mechanical seal. So what are the general conditions? Wear tracks on seal faces for secondary seals, elastomers. Chemical attack of material. Sleeve and elastomers damage. Drive pin and anti-rotation slot wear and crack or breakouts. If there is any axial or radial breakouts, then they should be noted. Shaft fretting. Condition of positive drives. Wear tracks on the seal faces. मूवेबिलिटी, वेदर योर सील मोशन इज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड और नॉट. इफ इट इज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड देन इट शुड बी नोटेड वाई इट इज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड. क्रैक्स और ब्रेकआउट्स, एनी क्रैक्स और ब्रेकआउट्स विच आर विजिबल ऑन द रोटेटिंग कंपोनेंट एंड स्टेशनरी कंपोनेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल सील फेसेस. वी हैव टू मॉनिटर कंडीशन ऑफ द सील फेसेस. सो वॉट वी हैव टू ऑब्जर्व, यूनिफॉर्मिटी ऑफ वियर पैटर्न, वियर ट्रैक्स, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ क्रैक्स, ब्रेकआउट्स, ब्रेकआउट्स एट द कॉर्नर्स, केमिकल अटैक ऑफ मटेरियल. एंड वॉट वी हैव टू ऑब्जर्व ऑन सेकेंडरी सील्स सच एज इलास्टोमर सोरिंग्स, इलास्टिसिटी, वियर ट्रैक्स, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ क्रैक्स, केमिकल अटैक ऑफ मटेरियल. इन दिस पिक्चर यू कैन सी दिस इज ए एब्रेजन मार्क ऑन सील. सो दीज एब्रेजन मार्क्स में अकर ड्यू टू फॉरन पार्टिकल्स इन द सील चैम्बर. हीट डैमेज, हीट डैमेज टू द सील फ्रॉम एक्सेसिव टेम्परेचर. द रिजल्ट इज ए हार्डनिंग ऑफ द इलास्टोमर विच कैन कॉज परमानेंट डिफॉर्मेशन, डिसकलरेशन, क्रैकिंग एंड मेटेरियल ब्रेकिंग ऑफ. फ्लैक्स फटीग, फ्लैक्स फटीग फ्रैक्चरिंग द डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द सील अंडर प्रेशर क्रिएट टेंसाइल स्ट्रेसेस दैट कैन फटीग एंड फ्रैक्चर द सील मटेरियल. मेटल कंटामिनेशन, हियर यू कैन सी मेटल कंटामिनेशन इन दिस फेसेस. दिस द मेटल इज कंटामिनेटेड विद द फ्लूइड हैंडल्ड और द सीलेंट विच इज यूज फॉर द कूलिंग और लुब्रिकेटिंग ऑफ द सील फेसेस. सो वी हैव टू एनालाइज प्रॉपरली द रीजंस ऑफ डैमेज ऑफ मैकेनिकल सील. प्रोसीजर टू रिकंडीशन सील फेसेस. द डायमेंशन ऑफ द सील फेस थ्रू आउट द सर्कमफेरेंस आर नोटेड. द स्क्रेचेज हैव टू बी स्मूथनड आउट. इफ देयर इज ए वेवी पैटर्न द क्रेस्ट हैव टू बी रिड्यूस्ड. दिस फेस इज देन फिक्स्ड ऑन सरफेस ग्राइंडिंग मशीन फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ फेस ग्राइंडिंग. सो वी विल डू ग्राइंडिंग ऑफ द सील फेस. द ग्राइंडिंग ऑपरेशन इज कैरिड ऑन दिस मशीन फॉर अबाउट 4 to 6 hours डिपेंडिंग ऑन डेप्थ ऑफ ग्रूव ऑन द फेस टू अचीव ए सरफेस फिनिश ऑफ अराउंड 8 micrometer to 20 micrometer. देन वी हैव टू डू लेपिंग ऑफ द सील फेसेज. द फेसेज हैव टू बी मेड फाइन एनफ बाई लेपिंग मशीन टू अचीव द रिक्वायर्ड आउटपुट ऑफ लेस देन 3 micrometer सरफेस फिनिश. पॉलिशिंग, सब्सिक्वेंटली पॉलिशिंग ऑपरेशन इज कैरिड आउट ऑन द सील फेस टू अचीव ए फाइनल सरफेस फिनिश ऑफ 0.05 micrometer to 0.2 micrometer. सो लेट अस नो हाउ ग्राइंडिंग ऑफ द सील फेसेज इज कैरिड आउट. यू कैन सी ए पिक्चर ऑफ लैप मास्टर वोल्टर सिंगल साइडेड फाइन ग्राइंडिंग मशीन. सो ग्राइंडिंग इज कैरिड आउट टू अचीव सरफेस फिनिश विद एब्रेसिव मटेरियल्स ऑफ हायर हार्डनेस देन सील फेस मटेरियल्स. सीमेंटेड कार्बाइड एंड टंगस्टन कार्बाइड पार्ट्स कैन बी फिनिश्ड टू द रिक्वायर्ड फ्लैटनेस एंड सरफेस फिनिश बाई यूजिंग डायमंड व्हील ग्राइंडिंग. ग्राइंडिंग व्हील ऑफ ए रेजिन बॉन्डेड डायमंड एब्रेसिव व्हील कैन बी सेलेक्टेड फॉर सरफेस ग्राइंडिंग ऑपरेशन. हियर इन दिस पिक्चर यू कैन सी हाउ सरफेस ग्राइंडिंग ऑफ द सील फेसेज आर कैरिड आउट. After grinding operation of seal faces, we have to carry out lapping of seal faces. You can see a picture of lapping machine where rotary seal face and stationary seal faces are lapped. Lapping is a procedure in which two surfaces are rubbed together with abrasive between them to give tight tolerance in surface flatness and finish. Lapping operation is performed with the help of a lapping machine where the workpiece is placed in conditioning rings on a rotating lapping plate with a prescribed thin layer of abrasive. So in this picture you can see rings which are to be conditioned are placed on the lapping machine, and this rotating lapping plate will rub over the seal face by providing a thin layer of abrasive. The workpiece does not come in contact with lapping plates, but the loose and rotating abrasive particles transfer cutting energy from lapping plate to workpiece so as to produce the desired surface finish. Lapping is required to achieve flatness of the seal face and a surface finish. So this is a very important operation and this should be done very carefully. After lapping of the seal faces, we have to do polishing, the final finishing of the seal faces. You can see a picture of Lap Master Wolters polishing machine where polishing of the seal faces are carried out. After the lapping, the work pieces are transferred to a polishing plate. In this process, a smooth and gentle rubbing of the faces on a polishing plate with a still finer abrasives gives a mirror finish to the seal faces. An oil soluble diamond paste in the form of slurry is used as the media to remove the stock of the seal faces. The fluid can polish hard to reach surfaces and leave an even and smooth finish all over the seal faces. The finest diamond paste is used for the final polishing and achieving a mirror finish on the seal faces, and subsequently polishing operation is carried on the seal face to achieve a final surface finish of 0.05 micron to 0.2 microns. After polishing of the seal faces, we have to check the flatness of the seal faces. So for checking of flatness of the seal face, we have to use light bands. You can see a picture of a Camet light band machine. Light bands form by using an optical flat and a monochromatic light source. You can see in this picture, the machine here, from here light will occur. This is a seal face and this is a optical flat. So this system is checked used for checking of surface flatness. The monochromatic light on which the following diagrammatic interpretations are based comes from a sodium filled tube source which eliminate all colors except a yellowish orange. Light band readings are a very valuable way to check the improper lapping. So take notice of the light bands that are visible on the reflection of the face. Laying a straight edge on a tangent to the inside circumference of the face, how many light bands are crossed? So that we will discuss in our further video. How to interpret it? The mechanical seal flatness shall be within 2-3 light bands for a smooth functioning without leakage. So our flatness of the seal faces should be within 2-3 light bands only. Wavelength of sodium light is 589 nanometer. One sodium light band is equal to 0.29 microns. So any particles or smears on the surface of either the component or the optical flat will affect the measurement. The light bands are made up of bright and dark fringes which are appear on the optical flat. So how to read light bands with an optical flat, which will ensure that the seal faces are properly reconditioned and can be reused. So you can see a picture of optical flat, this, and this is a sodium light source and this is our seal face. First clean the surface of the component and optical flat with a lens tissue or soft lint free cloth. Both faces must be absolutely clean, and we can use acetone also for cleaning of the seal faces. Place the optical flat carefully on top of the component. Do not slide it across. As the optical flat and components come together, lines will appear through the flat. So you can see lines here on the optical flat. From this is our eye. Manipulate it to obtain a line pattern as illustrated. The lines are interference fringes or bands. and are an indication of the level of the component surface has risen or fallen in relation to the optical flat. Here you can see fringes are showing perfect flatness of the our seal face or a part. How to check flatness through light bends for flatness of seal face? So here you can see this is our optical flat and this is our seal face. So here this is a one light band. So you can see this is our reference line, this one, and it is here cutting only a one fringe. So this is flatness is under one light band. Here you can see two fringes are cut here from by the reference line. So this is in two light bands. Here it is similarly in three light bands, and this is in nine light bands. So a better surface flatness we have to be within these three light bands only to achieve a leak free mechanical seal faces. Here you can see the flatness error of one fringe is lambda by 2. Perfectly flat test piece will be visible like this. Inspection and testing of mechanical seal. Inspection for surface roughness and flatness that we already discussed. The polished faces will be inspected under monochromatic light and reflex viewers. The faces are deemed to pass the test if 2-3 light bands are visible on seal faces. If light bands are beyond the limit or not visible at all, the face should be relapped till the permissible limit is achieved. After flatness and surface finish, we have to hydro test the mechanical seal. The polished seal faces are assembled into the mechanical seal cartridge and then hydro tested using a seal hydro tester under 1.5 times the operating pressure, which usually are in the range of 5 to 9 kg per centimeter square. Those seals that pass this standard test are put into assembly for operation. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.